What's going on, everyone? Kellen Reck here. Today I want to show you a quick tutorial on how to 3D camera track in Adobe After Effects. We're just going to do a quick example with text so that you can see how this effect works and how easy it is for you to do on pretty much any of your shots. So let's dive into After Effects, and I'm going to use a drone shot that I got here up in Maine, and we're just going to track some text to this house, and you can see how really easy it is. So let's drag this into a new composition. Just drag it over this composition icon here. And this will make a composition that is the same size as your footage and is the same time as your footage. So right at the beginning of our clip here, my drone flies just past this house, and I want to track some text right to the edge of the top of the house here so that we can see the text sticking to the house as the drone flies right past. So what do I do? Well, there's a couple ways you can do this. The way that I like to do it is if you go to your effects and presets and you look up the 3D camera tracker, you'll see the effect right there and you can just drop that right on your clip. The other way you can do it is go to window and tracker, and that'll pull up your various tracker settings. If you click on your clip, you can track camera, track motion, and then all of the warp stabilizer options as well. Track camera is the same thing as the 3D camera tracker. Track motion is a different style of tracking that I'm gonna go over in a separate video. So let's do the effect and preset here. I'm just going to drag this on top of my clip. And what it'll do is the 3D camera tracker is going to analyze the entire clip. So this could take a while. You see that up at the top, you can see it's initializing, and then it'll go frame by frame as it analyzes your clip. Now, the bigger the clip again and the longer it is, the more time it will take. So what I'm actually going to do here, this is 700 frames. I'm going to cancel this effect. And all I need is the clip to go to about here. So I'm gonna actually get rid of the rest of it so that this goes a little faster for you. And we'll drag the 3D camera tracker right back on there. And again, it's gonna analyze your clip. And there are some advanced settings so that you can change the solve method and you can do a detailed analysis. Those you might have to get into if you have a more complex movement in your shot, but for a simple drone movement that's very smooth, all you really need is your basic 3D camera tracker. Now, as this runs, just want to talk a little bit about what the 3D camera tracker is. It is a camera tracker, exactly what the name says. So what it's doing is creating a virtual camera. The camera in this shot is the camera that's on my drone. It's moving through the shot. The 3D camera tracker is basically building a virtual version of that drone camera so that we are able to determine various points in our footage and then attach either text or solids to those clips. So once your tracker is done analyzing, you'll notice that your footage now has, if you click on the footage and click on your 3D camera tracker, you see there's all of these points. And when you go over the points, colored points, you get a target, bullseye. Now what that is doing is these points are all tracked to your footage. And when you click on them, it'll make a triangle, and the bullseye is the plane at which you're tracking to. So you can see here we've got, you know, various planes on the trees, various planes on the house and the windows and the chimney here. And you can also select a whole bunch of them by clicking and drawing around them, and that'll create a plane of all of these points. So what I want to do for this footage is create a piece of text that is tracked right to this edge of the house. So we fly right through it. So what I want to do is track right on this edge plane here. So what I'll do is I'll go in close to this edge, and you can see all of these points that make up the edge of the house. And I'm just gonna circle a bunch of them, trying to make sure that it's all on the same plane. And I don't need to get them all, but you can see that I've got basically all the points, or most of the points, that are making up the edge of this house. And you can see there's some on the ladder here if you wanted to track to that. I just wanna track to the same sort of Z distance that that house is on, that edge of the house. So once I have them all selected, I right click and I have a whole bunch of options. I can create text in a camera, solid in a camera, null in a camera, and all of these different things can be used in different ways. If I wanted to create a solid, I could then add an image to the edge of the house, or I could add a video to the edge of the house. But for this, I just want to do a simple text in camera. So now you can see we've got our camera built that will travel through the scene, and we've got our text that right now is tracked to the edge of the house. So let me let this play out for a minute, and you can see our text fits perfectly on the edge of the house, no problem. It's stuck right to it. And obviously this is playing back a little slow because it's a heavy project here. Cool. But what I want to do is I want this to swing out so that we fly through it. So once you have an element tracked, and you'll see that this text, if you look down here, is marked as a 3D object. That makes itself that way once I've created that. Once I right-click and do text and camera, it makes a 3D object, and that's how it travels through 3D space here. So what I can do at this point is if I click and drop down to transform, I have the option to actually adjust and rotate my text here. So let's see, let's move it in Y space so that it runs along the wall, the opposite of the wall, and then I can move the position to and just move it out. I could also just click and move it out so that it pops off the wall a little. And then you can change your text. So we'll change this to say motion track, and we'll move it out a little more. And you can still rotate as much as you want so that it lines up properly. So you can move all of these elements and the tracked object will still follow wherever you were tracking from. So it's still tracked to this edge of the wall, but I can move it in various places and rotate it any way that I need. Now you'll see as I move, we'll get closer and we'll just fly right through that object. Now, if I want it to fly directly through the middle, I can just move it a little bit more. As much as you need, you can scale it up if you want, and that'll do for what I'm trying to get here. And we'll just fly right through. And if you see here, once we get close to it, I actually don't have enough. So I can just drag this out and we can finish the tracking. But you can see that this is doing exactly what I want it to. And it's really as easy as just letting the 3D camera tracker play out, right clicking, and then determining whether you want a text or a solid, and then having it track to your scene. And it's really easy. You can change the color of this. You can change the texture. You can do anything you want with it. And obviously this needs to analyze again because I didn't make it long enough. Easy enough. It's just going to analyze those extra frames and we'll fly right through the text. So basically what I want to do with this video is just show you that it's not very hard to track things. You'll see people like Peter McKinnon and other YouTubers who do these types of tracking points, and they just sneak them into their intros or their outros and they'll do little titles with them. And this is all they're doing. They have a moving clip, toss your 3D camera tracker on top, and then create your text or create your solid or your null and attach various objects to it, and it'll track to your scene. It's super easy to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I want to do more videos on motion tracking because there's a few other ways to do it in After Effects for those tricky clips that have a little bit of a more difficult motion. This clip, because it's the smooth drone, is pretty easy to track, but there are other types of shots, handheld shots, that are a little bit more difficult. So I hope you enjoyed. I hope you can use this in your videos. I'm posting videos every Wednesday at 10 a.m. with the goal of helping you become a better photographer, better filmmaker, and I think we can do this together. So come on back, like the video if you enjoyed, leave a comment if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. We'll check you back in the next one.